Zdravím vás, milí priatelia. Práve sledujete úplne prvé video z takej našej série, ktorú sme vymysleli tu na rodnom dome Deža Hoffmana v Banskej Štiavnici. A našim cieľom je prinášať vám pravidelne kvalitný obsah, ktorý by ste mohli sledovať, rozhovory so zaujímavými ľuďmi, takými, ktorí vás inšpirujú. A dnes tu máme jedného veľmi vzácneho hostia, ktorým je Kristián. Kristián, ahoj.
Ahoj, ďakujem veľmi krásne za pozvanie. Som veľmi rád.
Taktiež sme veľmi radi, že si prišiel a ja osobne som veľmi rád, že sa môžeme s Kristiánom porozprávať a že ho môžete takto spoznať, pretože je to veľmi zaujímavý človek, ktorý žije tu v Banskej Štiavnici a tým, že nepochádza zo Slovenska, tak nám možno bude vedieť povedať aj nejaké rozdiely v tom, ako hodnotí možno život na Slovensku alebo ako vidí život vo svete, takže myslím si, že dnešný rozhovor bude naozaj zaujímavý a že sa máte na čo tešiť. Takže môžeme začať, ideme na to. Čo je v tvojom živote najväčšou vášňou?
Dobre. My greatest passion, I think, is to communicate in different ways, with different tools, but I started making magazines, rock magazines, I wrote some books of poetry, some tales. I get involved into graphic design, which I really love, and editing video also. I was drawing comics, a cartoon character, writing for interviews, making interviews for television also. So my area of action is really very diverse, and depending on what I want to communicate, I use the different tools. For example, in the radio, which I forget to mention and is a very important side of my career, I have a radio online almost 10 years. I really appreciate to know the others and to try to discover what connects us. So the feelings, the emotions are always present, and in this particular moment I am very passionate about the music. I am composing music in this pandemic time, and I think that that's something important for me because I feel that I can bring something honest and true.
Ty si spomenul, že veľmi rád spoznávaš druhých ľudí, komunikuješ, rozprávaš sa s druhými ľuďmi. Čo si myslíš, čo má Slovensko spoločné s Argentínou a Slováci s Argentínčanmi? Argentína je pomerne odlišná krajina od Slovenska. Má takmer 7000 metrov vysoké hory. My máme nádherné vysoké Tatry, ale až také vysoké nie sú. Argentína leží na brehu oceána. My nemáme more, ale za to máme veľa krásnych tajchov, napríklad tu v Štiavnici. Ale napriek tomu, čo si myslíš, čo máme spoločné?
Well, I don't know really how many Argentinians are living in Slovakia now, but as I know, in Argentina there is a huge community of Slovaks, around 80,000 people, which is a lot, really. I think we have in common, for example, if you think about Argentina, we are a country with a huge percentage of European immigrants. So in some cities you can catch this kind of architecture, and this is something that sometimes reminds me to some places in Argentina. Of course, Štiavnica is very special, really. We have in common maybe certain kind of European root. My grandmother was Italian. I have German ancestors, also Spanish ancestors. Slovakia gave us a couple who migrated to Argentina, escaping from the Nazis. They bring to the world one of the biggest Latin American poetries, which is Alejandra Pizarnik. So I think we have in common also these kind of connections. And we both country went through deepest and hard political times. In Argentina in the 70s was a big military dictatorship time, and I think that I can't talk deeply about communism because I feel that this is a very important and special topic here, but I think that this new democracy is also something in common with Argentina. Maybe we are a little more experienced about the democracy, but I think the communism also left an important footprint in the character of the people here. So we have in common also the need to find our new voice in this war concert of countries and political situations.
Čo si myslíš, že možno majú Slováci a Argentínčania spoločné v takom úplne bežnom živote? V takom každodennom, v rodine, s priateľmi, v práci? Čo si myslíš, že by tam mohlo byť spoločné?
To je ťažké otázka. Because I think that Slovaks have a very special way to approach the family concept, you know? Maybe in the past, in Argentina, it was stronger. I remember when I was a child, we were meeting with my tieta, aunt and uncles and cousins, and we were eating all together, you know. But I think that in the upcoming time, in the next time, it get lost. But in Slovakia, still this situation of the family meetings, and I think we are friendly, very friendly Argentinians, probably as Slovaks are, but the way to reach that point is different, you know. Maybe we are more warmer. I think a lot about it. Maybe it's due to the weather also, you know, not only this political heritage. And in the work, for example, we have small things that made the situation different. For example, we share mate. Mate is an infusion that, of course, in this time is hard to share. No, it's not recommended. But it's like a chai, and you suck and pass to the others. And you can do that even in the work and even with people that is not very close to you, you know. We hug each other, for example, you know. And I don't know how to find the common things, because I think that essentially we are all humans. We all have feelings, we all have fear, love, we want to be happy, you know, and these kind of things unite us not only as Slovaks and Argentinians, but as humans all over the world, you know. Both society in that sense are very similar, but in the shape are quite different.
Každý človek, ktorý niečo tvorí, alebo čokoľvek sa snaží v živote dosiahnuť, nezáleží na tom, či ide o umenie, o kultúru. Každý sa snaží svoju prácou niečo prezentovať. A toto je možno dôležité si aj uvedomiť, že naozaj každý človek svojim životom prezentuje nejaké myšlienky. A mňa osobne by veľmi zaujímalo, že čo sa snažíš komunikovať ty.
I think that in general the art have the virtue to unite people. For example, on an exhibition, photo exhibition, like in this place, or in a concert, everyone are under the same situation, no? So, in my point of view, and what I am trying to reach is to catch that attention in order to generate a reflection or appreciation of beauty, or to move some energy, you know? I think that in the case of music, which is really very special, I think that the sound and the frequencies of the music are a great gift that we have as human beings, you know, because it's really universal, the music. It's really universal. And it has the power to change your mood. You can verify this because each one of us, at least once a day, is connected to the music. So I have different projects around the music. One is a DJ project, which is called Mira Tus Manos, Look at Your Hands, and was the name was inspired in the book of Castaneda. This project is tended more to put the people to dance. So I am mixing Latin American folklore, but now also Slovak folklore with electronic bass. And I think people really need it and like it, which is very nice for me. Other project is It Rises All Nectar, which is an anagram of my name, but I did it at this way because I would like to interact with other people, not as a solo project, even if the songs starts by my side, but I am composing music to share with other musicians around the world so they can complete with their instruments, and then we generate something kind of collective. Then I was collaborating with Ivan Amer, which is a Slovak singer and composer. And finally this year, and due to the support of Hudobny Fond, I was making a piece inspired in Banská Štiavnica, in the landscape. I think and I feel that it's also a great gift in my life to have the possibility to live here, to walk these streets, to breathe this air, to... It's an amazing place, really. And this project is more in a symphonical way. I did something similar for theater, for Divaldo Poton, but in this case, I was just trying to catch the feelings of the landscape and returning into music. So it's a huge question also, Shimon. What I am trying to communicate or to express with my work, I could say that to move emotions internal and of other people.
Pokiaľ sa vrátime ešte trochu k tej práci, ktorú si robil pre divadlo Potôň, a to bola, ak sa nemýlim, Pastierska symfónia. Ty si bol aj ocenený za túto tvorbu. Je to tak, alebo sa mýlim?
Yes, that work we made with Ivana Mer. We were working with Potôň for two inscenáci. The first one was Amerisky Cesar, who won the Doski Ceny as the best performance on theater of its year. And Pastierska Symfonia, we were nominated as best music of the season.
Teraz vám povieme takú jednu srandovnú historku, ktorá sa viaže k týmto kreslám, na ktorých práve sedíme, pretože tuto Chris sa stretol s jednou herečkou práve v divadle Potôň, ktoré spomínal, a táto herečka nám tu vlastne nechala tieto kreslá raz, keď sa tu bola ubytovať, s tým, že raz si ich možno príde zobrať. Takže to je celkom taká srandovná vec a práve vtedy sme sa vlastne stretli aj s Chrisom.
Áno, pravda. She was working in Pastierska Symfónia, where we met, and was very funny that one day I just went through this street and I just wanted to check what was inside, you know, and to talk with you. I didn't knew you at that moment, and Ella was here, and yes, she lent you these beautiful chairs that we are using now, so Ella, thank you, you are with us now.
Teraz sa dostávame k takej jednej možno trochu funny otázke tiež, a to sa týka kultúrnych šokov, pretože aj ja keď som cestoval po svete a navštívil rôzne krajiny, tak som zažil rôzne veci a rôzne veci ma šokovali, ale tak by ma zaujímalo, že čo šokovalo teba tu na Slovensku?
Česká otázka.
Snažil som sa vymyslieť také špeciálne otázky, prepáč.
Nie, ale je dobrá, veľmi dobrá. The first cultural shock, very important for me, was the social distance in times of not COVID. Because here people is very respectful in if you compare, as I told you before, with the Latin American mood, you know, we are a little warmer. So in the beginning I thought that there was a problem with me, you know. Why people is so distant? Why women give me their hands? You know, in Argentina we kiss each other. doesn't matter if you know or don't, you know, it's like normal. So this was a very important cultural shock. Another important cultural shock was how the punctuality works with the public transport. I was amazed on how o'clock were the buses and the tram in Bratislava. That was shocking for me in a positive way. But then I discovered that it's not the same for the train. You can lost all your day trying to make combinations, or so that was an important cultural shock also.
Ale niekedy môže byť problém aj to, že vlak alebo autobus ide oveľa skôr, ako by mal. A mne osobne sa teraz stalo, že som čakal na autobus a zatiaľ som išiel navštíviť moju starku a tak som nejak u nej sedel a sme sa rozprávali, dal som si nejaký čaj alebo čo a zrazu som sa pozrel von oknom a okolo mňa prefrčal autobus, ktorý išiel asi o 20 minút skôr, ako mal. A ja som ho tým pádom nestihol. Takže niekedy môže byť aj opačný problém.
One of the biggest one and that I am trying to go through seriously tento rok je jazyk. Lebo slovenčina je veľmi ťažká. A it's not similar to any other language that I knew before, you know, English, Spanish, French, I don't know. You know, Shimon, for me, culture is everything. I can distinguish between normal life and culture. Everything is culture for me. When you are going to kupić chleba na potravini, wiesz, všetko je kulturne, kultura. But these things were very, very important, no, the language. And in a more deepest way, I was shocked in a negative way about the, in some circles, about the discrimination to the different ones, to the immigrants, hey? Also about, you know, each country have their corruptions and black pages in the history, but here really touched me the murder of Jan and Martina. I think that it was not good and that was a kind of trigger for people to wake up, because finally I think that people have the power, really we have the power. Also I was walking these days here and in front of our cafe, still there, their picture, and they were so young, you know. It's a shame, really. To je hamba.
Ja osobne mám veľmi rád naše mesto, mám veľmi rád tajchy, mám veľmi rád architektúru a celkovo taký ten dojem, ktorý tu človek môže mať v tomto meste, že je to naozaj niečo unikátne. A ja osobne si veľmi vážim Štiavnicu, veľmi ju mám rád a práve preto by som aj chcel robiť také rozhovory so zaujímavými ľuďmi, ktorí prevažne teda žijú tu. Zaujímavé je to, že ty tu bývaš vlastne viac ako 3 roky a nestretli sme sa. Pričom Štiavnica je celkom malé mesto, takže mohli sme sa stretnúť aj skôr, ale nevadí, aspoň sme sa stretli teraz. Čo si myslíš, ako sa žije v Štiavnici? Prípadne, čo by mohlo byť lepšie?
Dobre, Šimon, ako ty hovoríš, Štiavnica je nádherné mesto. Krásne mesto. The winter time is quite long, but somehow Štiavnica have a magnet in my life, because I never planned to live in Slovakia and I didn't knew nothing about Štiavnica really, but one thing that amazed me was that one of the first time I watched in Google Maps the shape of Štiavnica is like South America, you know?
Yeah.
It's the same shape. So life here is beautiful because this place is blessed, you know? I think that is UNESCO protected town is a consequence of this place, of its beauty. It's a shame that, for example, sometimes I go for a walk and I see that there is a lot of garbage in the forest. And I think that this is something that really could be and need to be improved. I was living in Argentina, in Patagonia, for 3 years, which is an amazing place also. Bariloche is the name of the town. It's very similar to this part of Europe. Actually, there are many German people living there. Some foods or things around the culture are very similar, but also this behavior of the people, you know, garbage. This is something that could be improved. Also, I think that the tourists have to feel that this is also their place, you know. Even if they are here for one night, 2 nights, 3 weeks, doesn't matter. They need to feel that is their place also to take care of Chavnitsa. This could be a model city in many aspects. The idea that in this house was Dejo Hoffman, who was a guy who had and provoked a very big impact in the international culture, and he went out from Chavnitsa to the world, really working with the best musicians, the best actors, you know. It is telling us that anything is possible in any place, not only in a place like this one, who is blessed by God due to the nature and the buildings, you know. But I think that we need to consider that we are living in a very big family, really, as humanity, no? And Chavnitsa, inside of this big family, it's very nice. Yeah, Krasna Rodina, society here, when you are walking in the street and you can say hello to anyone, and somehow the others know that you are living here and they are trying to incorporate you to the daily life. This is, for me, is very nice. I think that here there is a nice challenge to generate more culture. It's a town that is demanding culture, you know, to unite each other. And even if you say, I guess you say that this is a small town, but even as a small town, I am discovering all the time new people, new places where I never were, not only in the nature, but also buildings, you know. It's amazing town, really. And I recommend to all the people that visit Chavnitsa, but as well, try to live there.
Úplne 100% s tým súhlasím s tebou, že aj mne sa veľmi páči, že aj človek, ktorý sa narodí v takomto dome, v malom meste, medzi horami, sa môže dostať do veľkého sveta a dosiahnuť čokoľvek. Dosiahnuť obrovský úspech a stať sa jedným z najlepších fotografov na svete všetkých čias, ktorého si vážia ľudia a kapely ako Beatles, Rolling Stones, Frank Sinatra, Charlie Chaplin, Louis Armstrong a mnohí ďalší. Každý môže dosiahnuť čokoľvek. Ak sa vám toto video bude páčiť a budete ho zdieľať, komentovať, tak dáme aj nejaké ďalšie pokračovanie na nejaké iné témy. Ale Chris, ak máš niečo, čo by si chcel ľuďom povedať, čokoľvek, nejaký odkaz, čo by si ľuďom povedal?
In this time, I think that we are facing a very hard time in which we can check where we are in standing in the life. Life is a gift that we don't know until when we will have. We don't know for how long we are going to live, or where, or how, or which one of our beloved people will be with us. So there is no time to lose. There is no time to lose, really. And in Argentina there is one musician talking about rock. He was a big devoted of Beatles. His name is Luis Alberto Spinetta. He have a song called Diamond Soul. It means like we have a diamond soul. We need to really make a work to make it as shinest as it could be. We need to look inside of who we are, but also who is in front of us and try to help. This is my message. Thank you, Šimon. Thank you very much. Ďakujem veľmi, veľmi krásne.
My ti ďakujeme, Chris, že si prišiel a ja verím, že sa vám toto video páčilo, priatelia. A ako som povedal, môžete sa tešiť na ďalšie. Nech sa ti darí, všetko dobré.
Ďakujem aj ja ešte raz. Ďakujem krásne.